keep fighting voices in my mind that say I'm not enough. Every single lie that tells me I will never measure up. Ooh, ooh. Am I more than just the sum of every high and every low? Remind me once again just who I am, because I need to know. Whoa, whoa. You say I'm loved when I can't feel a thing. You say I am strong when I think I am weak. You say I am hell when I am falling short. And when I don't belong, oh, you say I am yours. And I believe, oh, I believe what you say of me. Oh, I believe.
The only thing that matters now is everything you think of me. In you I find my worth, in you
I find my identity. Yay! Ba ba ba! Thank you! Woo!
You have every failure, God.
You have every victory. Whoa, whoa!
You say I'm loved when I can't feel a thing. You say I'm strong
when I think I am. When I am falling short, you say I belong. Oh, you say I am yours. And I believe, oh, I believe what you say of me. Glory. Hermosa. Thank you, Jesus. I believe. Oh, ba-ba-ba-ba, kaya-la-ba. Oh, I believe. Hallelujah. Woo! Hey! Thank you, Jesus. Praise the Lord, saints. Praise ye the Lord. I greet you all in Jesus' name. Once again, happy, happy new year. Amen. We just come to lift up the name of Jesus, the name above every name. The writer says that no man, no one can do you like Jesus. Hallelujah. The songwriter says nobody can do you like Jesus. You can look high, you can look low, but you can't find nobody that can do you like the Lord. I just come to lift up the name of Jesus. Jesus said, amen, to his disciples that if I be lifted up, I'll draw all flesh into myself. As he spoke, amen, about Old Testament scripture when he told Moses that the Son of Man, hallelujah, shall be lifted up like the serpent. You must understand, he was talking about his crucifixion, when they raised him and lift him up. Hallelujah. A public display. Amen. He gave up, amen, his life so we could live. The King of Kings and the glory of glory submitted himself. The Bible says he was humble. He was obedient, obedient to death, death on a cross. I greet you in Jesus' name. Let us pray. Let us pray. Eternal Father, gracious Lord, I call you Jesus. Father God, I thank you for allowing me to see 2022. I thank you for using me as a man, a messenger of God. I thank you for allowing me to suffer the things I suffered. To praise the Lord in the name of Jesus. Now, Father God, I come not by my own will, not by my own power, not by my own might, but I come by the Spirit of the living God. I come to talk about my God, Jesus. I come to tell everybody that God is still on the throne and he is in control of everything in Jesus' name. Now, Father God, I bind Jezebel. I bind every hindering spirit. I plead the blood of Jesus on Satan. I plead the blood of Jesus on every root worker in the name of Jesus. I cast down every hindering spirit and I command it to get out of this ministry right now in Jesus' precious name. Now, Father God, teach your word. Father God, make the teaching easy and I bless your holy name for it. Now, Father God, I pray for Paige Studios. I pray, Father God, that you still continue to do thus what you said you would do. You said that you would do a new thing. Lord God, I'm saying release it right now in Jesus' name. Father God, I pray for my team. I pray that you keep revealing yourself more and more in the name of Jesus. Father God, I pray that you mature them in the word of God. I pray that you make them the witnesses that you talk about in the name of Jesus. Now, Father God, remember your manservant today. Lord God, use me to your glory. Not my will, but let your will be done in Jesus' name. I pray, let the redeemed say amen, and it is so. Amen. Hallelujah to God. Saints of God, my text, thank you, Jesus, is coming. Amen. From the book, 1 Kings. Mm-hmm. Amen. The writing, 1 Kings, amen. Chapter 18, verse 1 to 4. 18, 1 to 4, 1 Kings. Praise the Lord. And the words of God are recorded like this. This is Elijah the prophet and Obadiah, the governor. The Elijah the prophet. I come to speak about the prophets. Come on, shout out. Verse 1 says, after a long time, in the third year, the word of the Lord came to Elijah. Go and present yourself to Ahab, and I will send rain on the land. So Elijah went to present himself to Ahab. My friends, Elijah is the prophet that God used to command rain. The Bible says it hadn't rained in 3.5 years. But when Elijah prayed, God sent the rain. Oh, God, God, Abasha. Verse 2. So Elijah went to present himself to Ahab. Now the famine was severe in Samaria. Obadiah, who was in charge of the palace, Obadiah was a devout believer in the Lord. Listen to this. While Jezebel was killing off the Lord's prophets, Jezebel come to kill the prophets. Every time I speak, maybe not here, but there, I bind Jezebel. Jezebel's after this. She wants the prophet. While Jezebel was killing off the Lord's prophet, I ain't talking about no sorcerer. I'm not a prophet that can stand in front of you and tell you you got on polka dotted underwear. I'm not a prophet that can tell you had French fries for supper. That ain't helping nobody. If I shout about that's not a prophet. That's a wizard, a sorcerer. See, he's doing things to edify himself, make him look special. The God's prophet speaks the word of God. Oh, I just said, Holy Ghost, right over their head. Huh? Come on, somebody. Come on, somebody. Now, the famine was very severe in Samaria, and Ahab had summoned Obadiah, who was in charge of his palace. Obadiah was a devout believer in the Lord. While Jezebel was killing off the Lord's prophets, Obadiah had taken 100 prophets and hid them in 2 caves, 50 in each, and had supplied them with food and water. Saints of God, my message today is the Lord says, break up the pity party. Oh, God, I come to teach. Break up the pity party. Amen. My friends, you see here when the prophet Elijah, who had killed 430 false prophets, when he heard that Jezebel had killed off 300 of the Lord's prophets, the Bible says that the Lord told the prophet Elijah to go show himself to Ahab. Praise the Lord. And the Bible says that when they received the word that Jezebel sent word to the prophet Elijah that by this time tomorrow you will be like the 430 prophets you killed. And the Bible says he went and hid in a cave. Obadiah hid him in a cave, 100 of them, 50 in one cave, 50 in the other cave. Prophets of the Lord, hiding from a witch. The Bible says the very thing that you run from will overtake you. I come to talk to you. I come to talk to you. I come to talk to you. Amen. Jezebel been after me before I even started trying to be a real preacher. You know, our part-time preaching. And Jezebel, come on, Jezebel is real. It's a spirit that's left in the earth. It's after the prophet of God. But God said, I give you power. See, I exercise my power. God says, you must speak to your troubles. Come on, somebody. Come on, somebody. Come on, somebody. You see, you got to wait to go to church to tell your pastor, your elder, your bishop, whoever, whatever you call him, whatever you call her, to lay hands on you. God said, I give ye power. Huh? God says, if you speak to your trouble, it'll hear me speaking. Huh? Come on, somebody. You see, every night I bind Jezebel. Jezebel is after this prophet, not trying to kill me outright, trying to make me go back to where God brought me from, trying to make me do cocaine again, trying to make me have a pity party. Well, I come to tell the house of bread and anybody that's listening, God told me years ago, break up the pity party. Stop feeling sorry for yourself. Stop worrying about all the money you spent on drugs. Stop. Break up the pity party. Because God made it plain to this prophet that if I come before the devil, amen, with a sorrow spirit, that the devil will come with every imp, every demon in the region and have a pity party in my mind all night long. Because, see, he will use against you the very thing you project in front of you. You got to break up the pity party. It ain't helping nobody. Sure, you did it. You may even do it again. But you ask God to forgive you. Break up the pity party. Is that looking... 1 Kings, I might as well hold this. Now look at 1 Kings 17. I'm going here. Break up the pity party. 1 Kings chapter, verse 17. Chapter 17, verse 2 to 6. Listen. Listen, wait a minute. God is going to speak to the prophet Elijah. Not Obadiah, not Ahab. They're not prophets. They're magistrates and, you know, overseers of the town. He's the prophet. Watch what God tells the prophet. God said, I'm tired of this. You know what? When God has strengthened you, given you power, given you intellect, insight, given you the spirit of prophecy, and you let a devil, a witch, or anything from the dark world shut you down, God says, break up the pity party. Parabusha, babaka. The word of the Lord came, this is chapter 17, verse 2. God speaking to Elijah. The word of the Lord came to Elijah. Leave here, turn eastward, and go in the Kinneth River, east of the Jordan. You will drink from the brook, and I have ordered the raven to feed you there. God said, leave here. Come out of that cave that Obadiah hiding people. You can't hide from a devil. Do you understand? See, the devil don't operate by earthly laws. Walls don't hold him. Windows don't hold him. Doors don't hold him. They just appear. Huh? Look. I thought you knew. I specialize in demonology. Yes, I do. Demons are real. Demons are organized. You ain't never heard no preacher that's a preacher preach about demons fighting each other. Have you ever heard that? You ever heard? And I preach some, never mind. Holy Ghost just quickened the bishop. He just quickened the bishop. And you would drink. I've ordered the raven to feed you there. So he did what the Lord had told him, and he went to the Kinneth River east of the Jordan and stayed there. The raven brought him bread and meat in the morning, bread and meat in the evening, and he drank from the brook. Do you know a raven is not a predator? He's a scavenger. Ravens eat dead things. Raven and a buzzard, they walk hand in hand. They ain't gonna waste no energy on trying to kill nothing. They eat roadkill. Anything that's already dead, he eats it. But God says what's impossible with man is possible. God will take a raven and make him feed his prophet. The raven brought him meat and water, bread. See, God, when he tells you to break up the pity party, he's putting you back in the game. But he knows that you've lost some nourishment. God is going to strengthen the prophet. See, when God tells you to break up the pity party, you know how he strengthens his prophets? He gives us an assignment. And that assignment is not only just to fulfill God's assignment, but it's to strengthen your confidence in God. Watch this. See, some of y'all got in relationships just since the new year has turned. You better hear the prophet. And now you ain't got a clue who this person is that you've been, oh, God. God said, break up the pity party. God said, you got to come out the same way you went in. Hey, you got to come out of a bad relationship the same way you went in it. God told him to come out of the cave. Now, he didn't say, go around this rock and there's a back entrance to get you out. God said, come out. You got to come out the way you went in. Oh, Wait a minute. Glory to God. Let's pick up 7:16, if I get there. Let's pick up 7. Sometime later, the brook dried up because there had been no rain in the land. Then the word of the Lord came to him. Then the word of the Lord came to the prophet Elijah. See, when the brook dried up, that assignment was over. When God gives the prophet an assignment, when that one's over, he gives him a new assignment. There ain't no, amen, vacay, amen, ain't no holiday, amen, because you must understand, when you accept the God as your Lord and Savior, and you say you are a soldier in the army of the Lord, God gives you your marching orders, and your marching orders is every day and every night. Ask me why. I know you was going to ask me, because the devil don't sleep. He don't take no time off. Hallelujah to God. What? Verse 7. Sometime later, the brook dried up because there had been no rain in the land. Then the word of the Lord came to Elijah, go at once to Zarephath of Sodom and stay there. I have commanded a widow woman in the palace, and I have commanded a widow woman in that place to supply you food. God told him when, amen, the brook dried up, go to Zarephath. I've commanded the widow woman to feed you there. You see, when God told him to come out and break up the pity party, God didn't pat him on the back or hold his head and rub his stomach. He sent him on another assignment. But this assignment ain't just for him. It's for the widow woman. God told me to tell somebody, break up the pity, but let me go here. Let me, okay. And then, so he went to Zarephath. When he came there, when he came to the town gate, a widow was there gathering sticks. He called to her and asked, would you bring me a little water in a jar so I may have a drink? And as she was going to get it, he called, and bring me, please, a piece of bread. As surely as the Lord your God lives, she replied, I don't have any bread, only a handful of flour in a jar and a little oil in a jug. I am gathering a few sticks to take home and make a meal for myself and my son that we may eat it and die. Now he knows his assignment. Now he knows his assignment. This woman was getting ready to commit suicide, homicide. She had been fed up with it. See, the pity party is designed to make you kill yourself. Amen. Or make you go out and somebody else kill you. The pity party make you so, amen, sorrowful feeling in your spirit, man. And she told the prophet, I ain't got enough for you. I'm going to make what I got left for me and my son. We're going to eat. I'm going to kill him and I'm going to kill myself. Homicide, suicide. But God sent the prophet to nullify Jezebel's attack, the attack that's trying to make her take her own life and a child's life, which will give the prophet confidence to get back in the game. You don't hear me? Somebody said, break up the pity party. Amen. Amen. Elijah said to her, do not be afraid. Go home and do as I have said, but first make a small cake of bread for me from what you have and bring it to me, and then make something for yourself and your son. For this is what the Lord, the God of Israel, said. The jar of flour will not be used up, and the jug of oil will not run dry until the day the Lord gives rain on earth. She went away and did as Elijah had told her, so there was food every day for Elijah and for the woman and her family. See, the prophet, if she hadn't obeyed the prophet, she didn't have to kill herself. She would have starved to death. Famine means there ain't no food, ain't no water in a place. But she obeyed the word of God through the prophet. And the Bible says that the flour never ran out. The oil never dried up. They ate every day, every day, every day, every day. See, God sent the prophet on assignment to break up that pity party. That woman had a pity party. She said, I'm going to cook what I got, and I'm going to give me some to me and my son. We're going to eat, and we're going to die. But God sends break up the pity party. God told me, tell the house of bread, just because it don't look good right now, I know you still don't understand this COVID-19. He said, but if you got enough sense to know that I am your God. He said, break up the pity party. He said, because every time you feel pitiful and sorry, the devil is laughing at you and he's planning or plotting to sit you in a trap. He said, but if you look to me like the God of all gods, the God of all grace, I'll bring you peace that surpasses all understanding, and I will bless you. I won't command a raven to feed you, but I have a stranger to knock on your door and give you a love offering. right now, because I'm the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, the God of Jacob. Let me close. Let me close in the name of Jesus. Let me close in the book of Jeremiah, the prophet. Amen. I tell you, I come to speak on the prophet. Praise the Lord. Jeremiah chapter 37. Help me, Holy Ghost. Jeremiah chapter 37, verse 11. Amen. After the Babylonian army had withdrawn from Jerusalem because of Pharaoh's army, Jeremiah started to leave the city to go to the territory of Benjamin to get his share of the property among the people there. But when he reached the Benjamin gate, the captain of the guard, whose name was Ajah, son of Shamariah, the son of Hananiah, arrested him and said, "You are distesting to the Babylonians." Jeremiah prophesied that Babylon, with King Nebuchadnezzar, was going to take Israel captive, and they didn't like it. So he went to the town Benjamin. That's one of the 12 tribes of Israel. Benjamin, the tribe of Judah. Amen. He's a tribe. And they arrested him because he was speaking about his God, because he told him that God said, break up the pity party. God said, come out the pity party. He says, you may be, amen, in bondage now. He said, but this bondage was sent not to destroy you, not to harm you, but to strengthen you. God, my friend, will allow the storm to come. You see, God will allow you to go through a bad time in your life. But God told me to tell you, take it on a chin. He said, suffering is a part of my living. You must understand that the resurrected Christ, he said, if I suffered, then you must also suffer. But I come to tell you, break up the pity party. Look up, because all good things come from above. Break up the pity party. Hallelujah to God. Get back in the game. Somebody say, I'm a soldier. I'm a soldier in the army. I'm a soldier in the army of the Lord. Break up the pity party. Get back up. Somebody say, we fall down, but we get up. Somebody say, we fall down, but we get up. Break up the pity party. Break it up. Break up the pity party. Thank you, Jesus. Hey, Ababa. Still hear a sinner's prayer. Break up the pity party. Ain't nothing to feel sorry about. Somebody say, I got joy. The Bible says that trouble may endure for a night, but joy come in the morning. Break up the pity party. Break up the pity party. Eyes have not seen, ears have not heard, neither has it entered the hearts of man what God is going to do when you break up the pity party. Hallelujah. Somebody say, celebrate. Hallelujah. The day of Jubilee. Break it up. I'm just still here. Jesus.